don't know if you know, my talk's going to be in Spanish. I hope that's okay. So my name is Enrique Morones Cariaga. I'm very proud to be with you here at my sister's alma mater, UCSD. And I want to talk about something that we all possess, which is called the power of one. And it's something that's very special to me and something that I've been blessed with the opportunity throughout my life to meet people or moments that have impacted me in such a way that we have been able to make change. So I grew up here in San Diego. I wear many hats. I've been in professional baseball. I'm a talk show host. I've started cultural institutions. I've started human rights institutions. And in all of them, the power of one has played a key role. And nobody has been more important to me in my life than my father, Luis Morones, from Mexico City, rest in peace. And he's the one that kind of laid the foundation, him and my mom, Laura. And my dad is my personal hero. And he definitely has the power of one. So here's my story about the power of one. Many years ago, I met a woman that has greatly influenced me, and her name is Ethel Kennedy. And when I met Mrs. Kennedy, she said, Enrique, I've heard about your work, the things that you do, and so on and so forth. Have you thought about moving back to your hometown? Because at the time, I was living in Los Angeles. And I said, yes, Mrs. Kennedy, I'm going to move back next year. So I moved back down to San Diego, and I saw that that was key because the work that I do, much of the work that I do, has to do with the region, Mexico, United States, San Diego, Tijuana. So here I am in San Diego, and I started meeting all these different people, and I started having all these different types of experiences. And one of the persons that I met was Mahatma Gandhi's grandson, Arun. And he went and gave a talk at my alma mater, the University of San Diego. So Mr. Gandhi's there giving a talk, and it's a talk about the power of one. And he says, one time I heard a story of a little boy that was walking along the beach with his son. And as he's walking along the beach with his son is picking up these starfish. And he's throwing these starfish into the ocean. So the father says to the son, what are you doing? And he goes, well, I'm picking up these starfish and throwing them into the ocean. And the father says, yes, son, I can see that, but why are you doing it? And he goes, Dad, it's so hot out here. The sun is so bright. The tide has gone in. These starfish are dying. They're dying. And the father says, yes, son, but there's thousands of starfish out there. What difference does it make? What difference can you make? And the little boy picks up a starfish and he says, it makes a difference to this one. It makes a difference to this one. Well, this one could be a person. It doesn't have to be a starfish. 2 weeks after I hear that story, I'm out in the desert wearing one of my many hats, and we're trying to save people's lives. People that are crossing borders all over the world. Currently, there's 250 million people living undocumented in countries not their own. Well, this was two of them. I thought it was one, but it ended up being two. I had just heard the story. I'm out there, and we see this man stumbling along in the desert. So me and this other volunteer go running towards him to help him. As we got to him, we realized that one of the reasons he was stumbling, he was carrying somebody on his shoulders. And that person was almost dead. So we take the two of them, we put them in a safe place, and we tend to their needs. And after a few hours, we left. We left to continue with our work. Well, 2 weeks later, I get a call. And this young boy says, hi, sir, my name is Francisco. You don't know me. But 2 weeks ago, my dad told me you saved his life. We live in Los Angeles, and we want to thank you. And I said, well, thank you. I'm glad that your dad's doing okay. How about your dad's friend? And he goes, what friend? And I go, your dad didn't tell you? Your dad was carrying somebody on his shoulders. I go, that's my new hero. He had done this. He hadn't even told his son he had done this. Well, 2 weeks after that initial call, I get a call from Pedro. And he said the same story. He was the son of the man on the shoulders. And he was calling me from Chicago. So the power of one, that starfish being a person, can really make a big difference. It can make a big difference for good, or it can make a big difference for bad. So for me, it was really important to take this in, because when I say, what can we do? I really mean, what can I do? What can I do as a human being? And I've met these incredible people along the line, and I have four of them that I'd like to share a story about. And they all have the power of one. The first one I like to call the power of love. And it was a young man named Jose. Jose was one of these people that crosses borders, crossing borders all over the world. All he wanted to do was make enough money to feed his family. That's the number one reason people cross borders all over the world. And just like the people crossing here or other parts of the world, most of them, more than 90%, have no legal way to get into the country. So when people say, get in line, what line are you talking about? There is no line. So this man was here. He was working. He was minding his own business. He's having a soft drink next to a little store out in East County, San Diego. And suddenly, these three young men come along, and they see him, and they attack him. They attack him, and they try to kill him just because he's Mexican. And they beat him almost to death. He's unconscious. The three people take off. Thank God somebody came along, and they found him. They found Jose. And Jose was able to recover. It took a long time. He still has half of his face paralyzed. So I got to know Jose, and he said, can you take me to churches and schools and community centers? Because I want to tell my story. And I said, what story? And he said, the story of love. I want to tell them that with what happened to me, I've converted that into preaching the power of love. I thought, that is way beyond my pay level. I don't know how I would have reacted. Had somebody done that to me, I have no idea what I would have done, but I know I'm not man enough to do what Jose did. And Jose is the power of love. Marjorie is the power of life. Marjorie was a young lady from Honduras that I met many years ago when I was in southern Mexico. I was giving a speech, and during my speech, this woman stands up because I asked the people while I was giving the speech, does anybody relate to these types of stories? And she goes, I do. She goes, I'm from Honduras. And when I crossed from Honduras through Central America, then into Mexico, I woke up on the riverbed as you enter Mexico in Chiapas, right across from Guatemala. And she said, there was an angel above me. And that angel is a woman named Olga, rest in peace. And Olga said, my daughter, I'm going to take you in. You've been injured. And she took her to her shelter in Tapachula, Chiapas. So she took her in and found out that Marjorie had been raped 6 times, that Marjorie was pregnant. And Marjorie eventually had a son named Diego. And she's sharing this story, and I thought, that is an incredible story, the power of life, the power of life. Because she was able to survive, she was able to give life. And now what Marjorie does to this day, she spends half the year back in Honduras working with people there, telling them the dangers about leaving your homeland. They don't leave because they want to. They leave because they have to. Just like your forefathers and foremothers, the overwhelming majority of you. Those of you that have European backgrounds, 200 years ago, your forefathers and foremothers came looking for life. Back then, there was no illegal way to come. People just came. Today, for most people, there's no legal way to come. So Marjorie was able to survive, and she spends half her life talking about life in Honduras and the other half working at her shelter in Tapachula, Mexico. That's the power of life. And then there's Luis. Luis was a young man that somebody contacted me and said, there's a guy here that wants to meet you. He says he knows about you, he's seen you, and so on and so forth. And I said, well, I'll be back tomorrow because today I'm at a funeral. I was at the funeral of a very dear friend of mine's wife. Her name is Elena Chavez. It was Cesar Chavez's wife. So I was up in Bakersfield. So the next day I come back down to San Diego, and there's a young man there, and it's striking when you see him because when I saw him, he's only half a man. He doesn't have one arm. The other arm, he only has a little bit of it. He doesn't have one leg. He was a victim of something called La Bestia. La Bestia are these trains, cargo trains that go through Mexico, and these migrants oftentimes will climb on top of the trains, outside on top, in a series of trains trying to make it to the northern border with the United States, or maybe get off halfway and settle in Mexico. Well, he was trying to get into the United States. So the trains are coming along, and he was on his 21st train, because some people think it's just one train. They hop on a train, get off, hop on another one, etc. He was on his 21st train. He had gotten to the Texas border. And just as he arrived, he fell asleep on top of the train. He fell off the train, and his leg was being crushed. Cargo train, a freight train. So he reached in to save it. He lost his arm. He reached in to save what was left of him, and he lost most of his other arm. And this is a person that I've met and I've gotten to know him very, very well. And I can't believe his spirit. I can't believe the power of his spirit. And even though he's a person that suffered this dramatic tragedy, he goes around now and speaks to communities, mainly in the United States, but in other parts of the world as well, talking about the power of hope, that there's hope. Even though he's had this situation happen to him, he still has hope. And he wants people to realize, do not risk your lives. Do not make that dangerous journey. Do not hop on these trains, etc. And to me, it is just overwhelming. He told me that the only time he's cried after he was released from the hospital, after spending several times in the hospital, was one time when he went home to Honduras, and he went to his family home, and he saw a guitar in his room, his guitar, because he used to be a great guitarist. And he realized, I'll never play the guitar again. But the music he makes in singing, the music he makes when he connects with children, when he shares these stories, that's the power of hope. That's the power of hope. And that's Luis from Honduras. The next one is a little more local. It's a young lady named Dulce. And Dulce is a woman that I met. I had seen her on television a few times and so forth, and I ended up meeting her. And I knew that she was undocumented. I knew that she was from Mexico. And as I got to know her, I said, what's your story? What's your story? And her story is the story of inspiration. And she says, well, I was undocumented, and my parents brought me here when I was little. So she's a dreamer. That's what they call the people that are dreamers. They didn't come. They were brought. So she had no choice in the matter. And she says, yes, and I grew up in Barrio Logan by Chicano Park. My family didn't have very much money. So like a lot of these families, they share a house with another family or two families or an apartment, etc. And I said, so where did you live? In the garage, in one of the other rooms? And she goes, no, my dad couldn't afford that. And I said, so what did you do? She said, my dad rented the dining room table. And I said, he rented the dining room table? What do you mean? And she goes, yes, that's all we could afford. And I thought, well, how does that work out? And she said, every night, we would go there into this crowded house, and we had the dining room table. So we would sleep underneath the dining room table. And I thought, how could that be possible? They would all gather underneath the table and sleep underneath the dining room table. And this young lady has such motivation and such inspiration that she decided she wanted to become an immigration lawyer. So she went to this great school, UCSD, for her undergraduate work, paying for it out of her own pocket. They don't receive financial aid. And then she went to law school outside of California. So she was always worried that she was going to be stopped and deported and so forth. And today, Dulce is an immigration attorney. She's part of DACA, Deferred Action for Childhood Arrival, and she's part of the lawsuit against Trump. That's an inspiration. From underneath of a dining room table, to being a person that's undocumented, suing the president of the United States, that's inspiration. So I've met these people, and I think, the power of one, the power of one, how much we can all do. We can all do, but we gotta do something. There's a woman that I remember her quote, and her name is Heather Heyer. Heather Heyer is a woman that was killed by the neo-Nazis back at the University of Virginia. And she said, if you're not outraged, you're not paying attention. Well, I'm outraged, and I'm paying attention, and I use these four stories as inspiration for me because I know I could do better. I have committed many faults like anybody else, but I try to do my best to correct them, to say I'm sorry, to say, what can I do to make this a better world? That's what the power of one is all about. That's what the starfish story is all about. And right now, when we're living in these times where we have the best of times and the worst of times, I just recently lost a dear friend of mine a couple of days ago. It was unexpected, a migrant. And so I was dwelling on that a little while ago, and I was reading, and I came across a prayer, which I wasn't able to remember, so I wanted to use this piece of paper to say it. You're all familiar with it. It's a very powerful prayer. It's the prayer of St. Francis. And in the prayer, St. Francis says, Lord, make me an instrument of your peace. Where there is injury, pardon. Where there is doubt, faith. Where there is despair, hope. Where there is darkness, light. Where there is sadness, joy. And where there is hate, love. Love is the answer. And love is not a word. Love is an action. And that's an action that we can all partake in. And I know that we all have our moments of despair, of sadness, of challenges. But you also have the option of exemplifying the power of love. And that's what I try to do with what I do. That's what I always remember when I think about the starfish story. And that's what I do whenever I see somebody that needs a helping hand. And I realize that I can lend that helping hand, just like you can. So I ask you, you know, think about it. Think about the power of one. Think about how you can make a difference, because we all make a difference. These four people, Jose, Luis, Marjorie, Dulce, they're out there making a difference. Had I experienced any of those situations, who knows what I would have done? I know I'm not to the level they are to be doing such great things for the world. Because in my life, whether it was in Major League Baseball or talk show host or being in culture or human rights, every day we have decisions to make. What am I going to do? Am I going to be silent and go along with what's going on? Or am I going to rise up and take action? I ask, take action. We all have the power of one, and use that power for love. Because like I always say, amor, sí se puede. Muchas gracias. Thank you.